Hello everyone and welcome to another JoyPad music reaction video with Mike here to listen to some songs and get my thoughts on them. I've gotten quite a few requests recently, so I'm trying to plow through them. Luckily, it's all for stuff I haven't heard before. If someone had requested something I heard before, I'd still do it, but it'd be a review. If it's something I've heard before, if it's something I've not heard, it's a reaction because it's my first time reaction to hearing it. Anyways, I got a request for Blue October, Hate Me. I have heard the name Blue October before, and it's highly possible I've heard some of their music before. But, off the top of my head, I cannot name a Blue October song that I have heard. Maybe I've heard this one. I don't know. I won't know until I start to listen to it. But, I don't even know their sound, man. I've done no research. You know, typically I come into these doing very little research, not even knowing the genre of what I'm going to check out. I find it more fun that way. Sometimes fans get irritated at me for not knowing the history, blood types, and genealogy of the bands. Cough, Nightwish fans, cough. There's a reason I don't do Nightwish videos anymore. Mostly because I'm not a huge fan, and if you're not a huge fan, people that like Nightwish will threaten your life, so we're just staying out of that. Anyways, I'm here to talk about Blue October. This is the song Hate Me by Blue October. Let's give it a listen.
Block out thoughts of you so I don't lose my head. They're crawling like a cockroach, leaving babies in my bed. Dropping little reels of tape to remind me that I'm alone. Playing movies in my head that make a porno feel like home. There's a burning in my pride and a nervous bleeding in my brain. An ounce of peace is all I want for you. Will you never call again? And will you never say that you loved me, just to put it in my face? And will you never try to reach me, it is I that want to say.
Hate me today!
It sounds familiar. I don't know if that means I've heard it before, but the other thing to make note of is that this song came out in 2006. This is 2006, I was a junior in high school, or a senior, depending on the time of year. And this is just, this sound is so, like, derivative and emblematic of that time period, and you can see it too in the fashion. They're wearing suits, they've got the black eyeliner. That was really, really a thing around that time. People like to call it emo. The whole like goth light slash emo style was really huge around that time, and this has that sound of that time. I'm trying to compare it to something. I don't know. Let me listen to it more, and I'll think about what it reminds me of. And like I said, I may have heard this before, but it's just like a vague memory, so I don't know.
I'm sober now for 3 whole months. It's one accomplishment that you helped me with. The one thing that always tore us apart is the one thing I won't touch again. In my sick way, I want to thank you for holding my head up late at night. While I was busy waging wars on myself, you were trying to stop the fight. You never doubted my warped opinions on things like suicidal hate. You made me compliment myself when it was way too hard to take. So I'll drive so far away that I never cross your mind. And do whatever it takes in your heart to leave me behind.
Hate me.
Hate me tomorrow. hate me for all the things I didn't do for you. Hate me in ways, yeah, ways hard.
Okay, so I feel like I may have heard this song before, but only once or twice. It's actually a really heavy song, like lyrically speaking. Yeah, I found myself mostly focusing on the lyrics. The instrumentation, you know, fine, passable. There were a couple more elements than your kind of standard rock band at that time. You know, you heard the piano, the violin, so a little extra there. The song construction, pretty basic, but like I said, I was mostly hung up on the lyrics, which, you know, like a lot of people, or, you know, I don't want to just say from my generation, but a lot of people in general suffer from, you know, some form of anxiety and or depression. So this kind of, you know, it has that vibe of just a lot of people don't, you know, thoughts of self-harm and suicide, things like that. And I know this is like super heavy or whatever. Some people will scoff at things like that. But a lot of times when you have thoughts of self-harm, and especially suicide, the thing that holds you back is not any form of love for yourself, or even in some cases fear of what lies beyond, or, you know, fear of pain or things like that, but it's how that will affect other people. And a lot of people think, will have that thought of, oh, you know, no one cares, but there's almost always someone that cares. And that's the thing that holds you back. Like here, it, you know, I don't know for certain, but judging from the video, the lead singer is speaking about his mother and how she stood behind him through everything, even thoughts of self-harm and suicide, and even perhaps through actions of those things. And if she were to hate him, you know, as the lyrics say, hate me today, it would be so much easier for him to go through with those thoughts or those actions. I need to cough. And that's something that you see a lot, like, if it weren't for, you know, my parents, if it weren't for my brother, my sister, my significant other, even in some cases, like, if it weren't for my dog, if I didn't have to take care of my dog, I would disappear. I would, you know, just go somewhere. But, you know, it's just one of those things, man. Like, there should always be a reason that you don't go through with those things. But yeah. So yeah, that's mostly what I took away from this. You know, the song itself was, like, decent, but the lyrical message is what really was, like, boom. Hit me. So, you know, I apologize if that got a little, you know, I don't know if that's what people want to hear when they watch music reactions, but that's where I ended up at. You know, if someone knows if there's a deeper story behind this song, I'd be fascinated to hear it. You can let it go down in the comments. And as I said, this was a request, so I'm very open to doing requests. I upload music reactions several times a week, three times a week, Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday. I also do gaming content every day. I'm a musician, I am a gamer, I am a nerd. I don't know why all these things can't be combined into one channel. Hopefully you'll check out both things, but if you're just here for the music reactions, hey, thank you. If you're just here for the gaming stuff, also thank you. But if you're here for both, that's great. Anyways, if you like what you saw, you can hit that JoyPad right there, click that subscribe button, and yeah, share the video if you feel like it. If you don't, that's fine as well. That's it though. Thank you for watching. Until next time, as always, I humbly ask that you stay joyful. See you then. Bye-bye.